Hello students, welcome to MJC Learning, Standard 12th, topic Introduction to SEO, that is Search Engine Optimization. And in today's session, we will be learning about optimizing a website. We will be learning part one of it and remaining in the next session. We have already learned about SEO as a technique for designing and developing a website to rank well in the search engines and improve the volume and quality of traffic to a website using search engines. Next, we will see what optimizing a website means. Your home page is the most important part of your website because it gives off the first impression. It is typically the most visited page on your website. It shares your mission, values, and goals and should quickly communicate to your audience how your product or service addresses their needs. So, your website needs to be optimized. The purpose of optimization is to achieve the best design relative to a set of prioritized criteria or constraints. These include maximizing factors such as productivity, strength, reliability, efficiency, utilization, etc. So, website optimization includes processes such as adding relevant keyword and phrases on the website, editing meta tags, image tags, and other components of your website to ensure that it is accessible to a search engine. When you start programming, HTML programs should start with doctype HTML only. In case of singular tags or empty tags, they should be self-enclosed. Order of tags should be proper. Recently opened tags will be closed first. These are some of the things you have to keep in mind when you are designing your programs for better optimization. So website optimization is important because it helps your website visitors to be more successful with their visits to your website. There are various sections of a website which will be optimized for better SEO. We will be learning two strategies here, that is page structure optimization and keywords. The first one is the page structure optimization. Page structure refers to how you organize your web page content. It deals with how the content is presented to the visitor. If you structure your website well, it will benefit from this. Users will find their way more easily and Google can index your URLs better. So you need to organize it neatly to make sure you, your visitor, and Google will be able to find what you are looking for. The structure of your site is also a guide to Google and therefore very crucial. So starting with the page title. The page title is the tag element on the page where it is most important to strike a balance between readability and SEO. Each of your pages and posts should have its own unique title. which includes the main keywords for that page. Title is the first thing that the user notices in the search results list while using Google for searching. The title designates the name of a web page, which gets displayed on the result pages as the clickable result title. Each title tag should be unique, descriptive about what the page is, optimized with a keyword, and under 60 characters in length. Here is a sample program explaining the page title. So starting with the doc type declaration, exclamation doc type HTML, HTML tag, head tag, and the title tag. So whatever is highlighted here, the text will be put in the page title on the topmost bar. So title given here is page structure with order of opening and closing tags, title close, head close, body close, and then the content is displayed. The heading as introduction to search engine optimization, SEO. So this will be in bold letters in the middle of the page in big font. Then there is a paragraph. Website optimization helps or higher ranking in search engines. Out of that, if I am highlighting this part, only the two words, then I have to put B and close B. So this part will be bold, highlighted, and these two words I want to underline. So I have to put U and close U. Search engines will be underlined. Close P, close body, and close HTML. So in this, here, the innermost tags are shown to be ending first, followed by the outermost tag. Close B is the innermost tag, which is closed. U is closed, and then only P is closed. That is the outermost tag. Again, the body, that is the outermost tag. That is closed after the content. And last one will be the HTML tag, which is closed. So here we have seen how to demonstrate the title tag showing the page title. Next is the meta description tag. Meta description tag are an important place to include relevant keywords for your content, as these are used within the search results when your page is listed. Meta descriptions are brief but vivid descriptions that expand on title tags, summarize a page's content, and tell the web users why they should read your content instead of somebody else's. The meta description appears below the title tag. Here I have shown the meta tag highlighted in bold below the title tag. So the meta description appears below the title and the URL, and it should be kept below 160 characters. The meta description should be used to boost your on-page SEO. On-page SEO, we have learned in the earlier sessions. So this tag boosts the on-page SEO, the content, how it is displayed. So here is the sample program. Again, the declaration at the head. In the head, the title is displayed as meta tag, and the meta tag here is written three times showing different values. So in the name attribute, I have put author as the value, and the content will be Balbharti. Meta name is equal to description. Here I have to write the description. What is the program about? So here my content will be search engine optimization. So I will put a image or a heading related to this content. And meta name is equal to keywords. When you log into Google and start searching about this topic or the image, what are you going to type? Give some keywords related to that. So here in the content, there is alt optimization of image. Here you can put commas and write so many keywords which are related to your search. Close head, the outermost tag is closed. Then the body starting, in that you display. Here there is only one heading display, the meta description tag. Close H1, innermost tag is closed first and then the outermost. Body close and then HTML program close. So in this example, the meta tag is used with important and valid keywords such as alt, optimization of image, all those. They are called as keywords from the viewpoint of optimization of IMG tag. Next is the heading tag. Headings are the titles you give to your content. And they should be in the highest level, that is the H1 format for best results. That should be highlighting in the top of the page. It is describing what is your page about. So this is the heading which will come on top of the page. Heading should focus on relevant and descriptive words. And while you can optimize them with keywords, don't stuff them. You can break up the content using subheadings. Put the heading with H1, subheading with H2, then another subheading if you have H3 you can put. So accordingly, it will give the headings in a higher to lower font. There are H2 through H6, which are subheading levels which you can use. So you, to break up the content, you can use these subheadings from H2 to H6, but without repeating keywords throughout the page. Keywords should not be repeated again and again. Breaking up the content into smaller sections and paragraphs makes it easier for people to read. So pages should have proper heading tags from H1 tag to H6 tags wherever required. All are pair tags from H1 to H6. You can use them how you want with the attributes also. So here we have a program demonstrating the heading tags. Doctype HTML declaration, the HTML head tag, the title tag, close head, body. In the body, you are going to put the H1 or H2, H3 tags till H6, which is at the lowest level. In the previous two tags, we had declared the title tag and the meta tag in the head section. Now this tag, the heading tag from H1 level to H6 level with its closing tags is to be put in the body section. So your topic should be relating to the content. H1 search engine optimization, that is SEO. This will be the title of the page. And H3 techniques of SEO. This will be the subtitle. So from the main title SEO, we are learning this title, techniques of SEO. That is the meaning of it. So how you want, you can use this. Again, if you have a sub-classification of techniques, you can put H4, H5 and list out the topics of that. So this is how the H1 tag works. At the fourth point, we are working with the IMG tag with the alt attribute. We have worked with the IMG tag in the earlier sessions also. IMG has so many attributes. Among that, alt is one more attribute which is used to put an alternate text. If you have an image on the web page. The moment I point out my mouse pointer, point out, no click, point out my mouse pointer on the image, it will show me a text as the description of the image or what is the image about. That is shown with the alt attribute. So using images without your content is a great way to make your site more visually appealing. You can utilize images to help improve your site SEO. All your uploaded images have titles, so treat them just the same as your page titles. Including relevant keywords can help people find your site when searching on Google Images. You can add an image also, you can put a text also, but a picture speaks more than words. So you can include alt text and descriptions for your images, both, making them even more useful with SEO. The alt text provides search engines with more information about an image, though it is typically used to describe images to web visitors. So alt text should be specific and descriptive of the image content, say 125 characters or less. And it should be optimized with a keyword also, or a phrase, only if appropriate. Alt attribute gives information about the image. So even if the image does not download, it can make the viewers understand what is the image about or the image related information. So here is a sample program describing it. The meta is described here, at the head, body. When I put IMGSRC, SEO.jpg, it will be a picture or an image showing the SEO. And when I point out on this image, it will display this text. Alt is equal to search engine optimization process. So here I have to show the description of the image. So when I put this highlighted syntax of IMG in the program, it helps you boost up your explanation on the image when you are working with SEO. So this is one more important strategy to give a boost to your page optimization. So these four things were included in the page optimization: title, headings, IMG tag, and the meta tag. Second point of website optimization is SEO keywords. Including relevant keywords throughout your content is very important, as it helps search engines work out what your content is about. SEO keywords are the important words and phrases related to the developed website content that makes it possible for people to search via search engines. You need to know how people are looking for information in order to make it easy for them to find you. So keywords, research, and analysis are the main part of SEO, as well as search engine marketing. Keywords must be researched and carefully selected, and they must be worked into content in a natural and seamless way. However, you should try not to excessively repeat and overuse keywords, which can lead to your website being banned from search engines. So do not use the keywords throughout the page again and again. To research keywords for your SEO strategy, you can make a list of important topics. See how competitors are ranking for these keywords. Use the Google AdWords keyword planner to cut down your keyword list, etc. All these things will help you for keywords in SEO optimization. So these were the strategies for optimizing a website. In the forthcoming session, we will be continuing this topic further with more strategies. Have a nice day. Thank you.